2021 will be remembered as the year of the NFT. The idea of tokenizing digital ownership took the world by storm, and the internet was flooded with profile picture NFTs, all the way from CryptoPunks to Pixelmons. People would mint NFTs and then try to sell them for a profit on the secondary market. Some made thousands of dollars of profit, while others were left holding their bags. This hyper-financialization of NFTs attracted critique from all around the crypto world, as thought leaders came up with ideas of how to steer NFTs towards more meaningful use cases. Popular amongst these ideas is Soulbound Tokens, or SBTs, originated by none other than the founder of Ethereum himself, Vitalik Buterin. Soulbound Tokens are NFTs that are non-transferable and unique to an individual, storing relevant data like education credentials, employment history, club membership, things like that. Just like how regular wallets hold driver's licenses or library cards, digital wallets can store the digital credentials of each individual in the form of SBTs. As the name suggests, Soulbound Tokens are bound to a wallet or an account for the entirety of their lifespan. Essentially, they cannot be transferred to any other users. These wallets or accounts are called the souls. SBT creator wallets, issuers, can issue an SBT to themselves or another wallet. But once issued, this recipient's wallet cannot transfer these tokens to anyone else. But Jamel, if I can't sell NFTs to anyone, what's the point of holding it? As the world moves towards more digitization, we need a way to establish trust and verify digital social identities. Why is that? Well, think of how DeFi loans currently work. To borrow any cryptocurrency, users need to deposit a collateral asset greater than 100% value of the loan amount. In other words, users can only get over-collateralized loans on-chain because of an inherent lack of trust. Since there is no identity attached to the borrower's digital wallet, the only way to ensure that the loan will be returned is by asking the borrower to deposit an equivalent amount or larger amount of asset as collateral. Similarly,
DAOs rely on
centralized apps like Discord to prevent cyber attacks. That's basically where an entity creates multiple identities to influence the voting and governance. This lack of trust limits the growth and development of the Web3 ecosystem. This is where the Soulbound Tokens come in. SBTs bridge the trust gaps for the decentralized world of Web3. Their non-transferability enables them to serve as a means of building social identities that allow protocols and individuals to function based on trust. Let's continue our example of DeFi loans to understand how this works. Suppose a lending protocol issues credit score SBTs whenever a wallet pays back loans. When this wallet then asks for another loan from some lending protocol, the protocol can simply do a risk assessment based on the credit score of the SBTs in the wallet. Then, issue an under-collateralized loan to this wallet, just like a TradeFi lender would look at a credit score before issuing a loan to someone. Similarly, SBTs can serve several other purposes as well. Digital CV for applicants that employers can immediately verify. House renting history that owners can verify before leasing out their property. Cyber attack protection for DAOs medical records management. Proof of attendance for events. However, SBTs are merely a few months old, and their implementation is not very straightforward. The various use cases and challenges are still being designed and fleshed out. In their purest and fullest expression, however, Soulbound Tokens stand to become a foundational element of the decentralized society movement, in which communities emerge around shared networks and goods that are owned and managed by the souls that use them.